episode 2 of the Cobbler's Hammer. This is a German number 3 Cobbler's Hammer from the mid to late 1800s. Okay, so we finished the head, we blued it, we cold blued it, we left the face natural. Okay, just cleaned it up. Really looks good. The bluing came out really well. We cleaned up all the burrs around where the handle goes in. Gonna make that nice and neat. And now what we're going to do is we're going to set the head aside and work on the handle. It's in pretty bad condition. We got a drill hole here. We got a lot of splitting on both ends. Probably the original handle. You got some spray paint here, looks like. Yeah, it's pretty bad. The owner of this piece wants to stay original. This handle is really not savable. A very strange shape here, too. The belly seems to be in the wrong spot for it to be comfortable on the hand. Okay, so at this point, what we're going to do is we're going to replace the handle, okay? We're going to use this donor handle from this hammer that we have here, okay? Because it is a good material, doesn't have any cracks in it, okay? But it is vintage, which is nice, and it'll go along nicely. It's got a similar shape, okay, to the original hammer handle, and I think it'll work out nicely, okay? So, circumference, the depth, similar, but it's got a nice end on it here. Really a good thing. Okay, the end on the existing hammer is really shot. I mean, the entire handle is shot. To make the cut, we're going to utilize our antique finishing saw that we did a restore on last week. First time it's being used for an actual job. Thank you. on this. This will bring out the grain and also add some protection. Going to let that sit overnight to soak in real well, and then tomorrow we will apply a protective wax coating to this handle. Okay, well, 24 hours has passed, and linseed oil is nicely absorbed into this handle. Okay, brought out the graining, looks really good. And at this point, we're going to seal this handle with some beeswax, okay? That'll seal it from the elements. It'll protect it. And it'll also bring out the graining somewhat. Make it really look good, in my opinion. Okay, so now we're going to reassemble the hammer. Got this marked L, the left side, looking forward, okay? Because I got a custom fit on this. We'll slide this on. Alright, so we got the hammer done. The cobbler's hammer is done. It's been completed. Came out really, really nice. The bluing came out great. It did a cold bluing. It really came out nice. We got the wedge in the top. This is solid, rock solid. Okay. Got a nice handle that pretty sure it's hickory. Based on the graining, it looks like hickory. It came from a 1930s, 1940s hammer. So it was a repurpose, and it worked out good. I think it worked out really good. At this point, I want to do a little something with leather. Okay, I was thinking about making like a leather pouch for it, a leather holder, something like that. But then I said, you know what? I think we should do something special. We should do like a leather handle on this, okay? Something right where your hand is. It's that, you know, this tool is in your hand as a cobbler, like, for many, many hours during the day. So I think that a leather handle on this would really, really make it special. It's kind of like a medium brown. This is all cowhide. I've got like another medium brown. This has got like a lot more grain to it, though. I don't know if you can see that or not. I think you can. Maybe a little tint of orange or rust, you know, so that looks kind of good. This piece has a lot less graining, very little graining, very tight graining. All right, I think they both look good. I've also got a piece of like a darker brown. It's still in the medium to dark brown family. It's got like a medium grain, so it's kind of, the grain is in between these other two. I think that would look good as well. And then I've got black. It's a nice thick piece of cowhide. These are all pretty much like 3 to 4 millimeter. This has got a pretty tight grain. That would look good too, I'm sure, because it would match the blue ink, which is essentially black. I think they all look good. I think they'll all work. So the last cobbler's hammer that I did, which was about a week ago, I did a black leather handle with black threading. So it's like the baby version. I think I want to use a different color. I do like the black a lot, but I think I want to go with a different color this time. But I think the black is out. This brown is kind of nice. Let's see what that looks like. I don't know. Looks good. But I'd say between these three browns, I'd say that one's out. I think it's between these two. I think this one looks really nice. I wanted something with more graining. So I might end up going with this. I think that looks great as well. Really good quality. It's got really great graining. I really think it's going to look good. And I think the owner of this hammer, who happens to be a really good friend of mine, will be thrilled with this piece of leather. Okay? All right, so we're going to cut that and be right back. So we selected the piece of leather we're going to use, piece of cowhide. And we're basically just going to put it in a section of the handle where your hand is. I've got a medium-sized hand. About 95 millimeters, which equates to 3.82 inches. Okay, so we'll do 'Doing here is we're cutting the cowhide to match the contour of the handle. That we're using is a contact cement all-purpose, highly recommended for use with crafts, especially or particularly for us, leather. Try. So we stitch the ends, make a nice double stitch on that. That'll look really good when that's around the handle. We're just going to tighten up the loose ends here. This muslin thread has a nylon component to it, so you want to melt the ends. That way it won't unravel. This tool here, it's basically a burnishing tool, but I like to use it also to get out any air bubbles, and also to help make good contact with the glue. Alright, so I've got two needles, okay, threaded, and because we're going to do what's called a baseball stitch, okay, they're going to cross each other. So we got the handle on there, nice baseball stitch, nice and solid. What we're going to do is we're going to antique that handle just a little bit. All right, so we're going to heat that up a little bit. Heat gun. And we're going to hit it with some beeswax. What a beautiful piece. It really is. Ready to go back to work for another 130 years. We blued it. We cold blued it. New wedge. Brand new handle. Well, not brand new, but a new handle that we requisitioned. And and repurposed from a 1930s and 1940s hammer, okay? Pretty sure it's hickory. We did American cowhide, medium, heavy grain leather actually, black muslin thread, and really, really liked the way that came out. I think it's one of my favorite tools, my favorite restorations I've ever done. All right, so